Hello and welcome to the latest video from iProspect Ireland TV. My name is Kevin McAuley and today we're going to show you how to set up Google Analytics filters as well as five essential Google Analytics filters and why you need them. So not having filters equals sad face. Now the reason for this is because Google doesn't apply filters to Google Analytics data automatically, and this might be bad because you might want to filter out certain types of traffic. For example, if you or people in your workplace regularly visit your own company website, then you don't want to be looking at that data because it's going to kind of skew the information in there and not going to give you a true picture of what's happening. You also might want to filter out traffic from people coming from countries outside of where you do business, as again, if you're making business decisions regarding your website based on that, then it's not giving you a fair and accurate picture of what your actual customers in your country are doing. So to set up this first filter, from the admin column, we want to go to the left hand column there where it says account and scroll down to all filters. And then we're going to select new filter. Now we want to give the filter an easy to identify name. So we're going to name this filter block internal traffic because we're going to use it to cut out any traffic from people in our own office or from ourselves. Now we're going to change the drop down there from traffic from the ISP domain to traffic from the IP address. And we just want to leave the drop down exclude as it is. And we want to put in our IP address there. So if you don't know your IP address, just go to Google and just Google what's my IP or my IP, and you should be able to get that easily enough. We're just going to use the default here example. Once you've got that done, you can apply it to different views, but for now, we're just going to save it and we'll apply it to different views later. And there we have a filter created for block internal traffic. The second filter that we're going to create is the exact opposite, and it's going to allow us to see the internal traffic only. So this is really useful for testing purposes and to ensure that your tracking or your goals are set up correctly, because you can just perform an action on the website, you can go look at this, the profile with this filter on it, and you know very quickly and easily if your tracking is working. So let's jump back into analytics and I'll show you how to set that up. So again, from the all filters column, we're going to select a new filter. We're going to call this internal traffic only. And we're going to change exclude to include. Include only traffic from the IP address. And again, you want to put in your IP address that we got before. And again, we're just going to save this and we'll add it to a profile later. Cool, so now we've got our first two filters set up and time to move on to the third one. So the third filter we're going to set up is just to look at traffic to a subdirectory. So this can be extremely useful for heavily trafficked areas of your website, such as your blog. So by now you should be getting the idea. We're going to go new filter again. We're going to give this a name like blog traffic only. We're going to change exclude to include. And we're going to change it from traffic from the ISP domain to traffic to the directories. And here we're going to put in the subdirectory. So we're going to put in blog, and it's important here that we put in the forward slash on each, at both before and after the subdirectory. And again, just save that and you will have your blog traffic filter. So the fourth filter is a bit of a techie one, and it's for filtering lowercase URIs, or basically the extensions of your URL. So Google Analytics will capture data as it appears in a browser. So it means that you can have two URLs that show the same content appear as two separate entries. So for example, if someone typed into their browser iProspect.ie blog in lowercase, and someone else did it in uppercase, then these would appear as two separate sort of visits, two different pages, when really they're the same page in analytics, and they'd be sort of doubling up on page views. So we want to cut that out. So we'll jump back into analytics and we'll show you how to do that. So again, we're going to select new filter and we want to give it a recognizable name. So we're going to call this one show lowercase URIs. Okay, this time it's going to be slightly different because we want to select a custom filter, whereas before we selected predefined filters. So we'll hit the custom filter radio button. And here we want to select the lowercase radio button. And in the filter field dropdown, we want to select request URI under the content and traffic. Okay, and that's it. Again, we'll save this and we can apply it to the profiles later on. So the final filter we're going to look at is excluding traffic from different countries, but this could also be used for really any geographic location. But we find it useful as many of our clients want to target Irish consumers only, and some things they might have a global website, so they just want to see what Irish consumers are doing on their website. So it's a great way to make sure their data is clean and we're cutting out traffic from other parts of the world. So again, let's jump in and see how we do that. So no prizes at this stage for guessing what we click. So we go new filter again. Again, we're going to give it a name. We'll call this one Irish traffic only. And this is another custom filter. And here we want to include. And from the filter field dropdowns, we want to select country. So it can take a bit of digging out, so just keep an eye out for it. And then in the filter pattern, we want to type Ireland. And again, we'll save this and we'll apply it shortly to our profiles. So there we go. We got five different analytics filters. Now it's time to see how we apply these to an actual profile, so that we can look at the actual traffic that is coming from these filters. So now that we have all of our filters set up, let's actually put them to use. So again, we're back inside the analytics account. We're in the right account. We're on the website that we want to look at the traffic on. And now we're going to go to the view or the profile, and this is where we're going to apply some of our filters. So we recommend as best practice to create a view before you add any filters that you're going to call unfiltered data. It's good to just keep this in the account so you can see what's happening without any filters applying to your account and looking at all the different traffic. But what we're going to do is we're going to create a new view, and we're going to call this view Ireland only. So we're going to apply the latest filter that we used, which was for Irish only traffic. I'm going to change the time zone to Ireland, and we will create the view. So the next thing we're going to do here in this view is to add our filter. So here we're going to add new filter. Nice big red button there makes it stand out, and we can either create a new filter, just like the steps that I've shown you before, or we can apply one of the existing ones, and that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to apply the Irish traffic only filter. I'll add that and I'll save. Now if I go back to my profiles, I've got various profiles I can look at. So I've got all website data and unfiltered data, which are pretty much the same. Every account will start with the all website data. And now I've got Ireland only. So when I want to just see what the traffic from Ireland is doing, I can just click on this view on this profile and I'll be able to see. If I want to create one for the blog traffic, I just go ahead and do the exact same again. And that's pretty much it. That's how you set up filters and how you use them on views. If you have any questions on any of that, please feel free to leave us a comment or reach out. You can get full step-by-step instructions on the blog at iProspect.ie/blog. Until next time, hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching and take care. Bye bye.